Hello, ladies and gentlemen. How's everybody? I can't hear you, of course. I'm wearing the shirt that goes with the jacket in the picture that I put up last week. Got a lot of comments on that jacket. And we were in Macy's and Lala's looking at clothes and I decided, let me try on some of these really loud jackets. And I didn't buy that, but this shirt's been hanging in my closet for like 5 years. I guess I wouldn't wear this live because you could see all the sweat on it, and I'm not sweating that bad yet. So anyway, I thought this would be funny to wear this shirt. I was thinking, Last in Line, we're playing at the Whiskey in California. I'm in California on Thursday. So I thought, maybe I'll wear this shirt. But I don't think it would make it through. Problem with these shirts, if you're a drummer or a musician that kind of gets sweaty on stage, these kind of shirts and this fabric does not absorb the sweat. And I know a lot of the drummers sweat, so stay away from these shirts. I don't know what the material is, but so we're playing three shows: Thursday at the Whiskey, Friday up a place called Roseville, which is 400 miles away. That's fun. And then what's the last one? Fresno. We like Fresno. That'll be fun. And then we're off for a couple of weeks, and then we do East Coast, another six shows, and then Vivian has to go off with Def Leppard, so we postponed the last five shows of that tour. But I'm going to New York, and I'm going to be at the Beatles versus Stones Rock Fantasy Camp, and that should be fun. I was looking forward to that, but then we got booked, so I couldn't really make it, but luckily they kept the advertisement. And I'm gonna make it. I gotta get used to my Ringo rolls. Yeah. Actually, some of those rolls, they're a little more complicated than they sound when you listen to them. If you want to get them exact, a little help for my friends. That's the feel. Good thing I wasn't playing that song. My feel would be. Oh, yeah. Back in the day when I was probably 14, 15, I was playing weddings and events like that with a little kit. I don't even know if I had floor tom. But I used to play fills in there to keep me awake. You know, because here comes the bride and the groom. Right? And the maid of honor. That's what developed my attitude of aggression. You know, I like to play aggressive, you know. I don't just play. Say, you go from this. Some aggression. It's aggression, baby. I'm getting warmed up for the whiskey because we haven't played. When's the last time we played? About 2 weeks ago with Last in Line. And that's another thing, you know, when you're not playing, you got some time off and you're not playing or practicing, you got to get warmed up, you know. So I stood here this morning. Last time I played was a Friday. I was doing a recording in here. And you got to warm up your body, you know. You can't just jump on and get on there and play loud with the band. You start getting cramps and stuff. So simple warm-up for me, for the left hand, because the left hand's a slower hand. I can't believe how much slower it is in this hand. It's weaker, you know. So I just do the old standard right, left, left, right, left, left. And it's a great exercise. Right, left, left, right. And if it's your right hand that's slow, go the other way. See? And that exercise is right, left, left. Same sticking, changing the toms. Comes the bride. Sorry. I get carried away. You know why? Because the drums, all these mics are in my headphones, so there's a nice live sound for me. So it allows me to play easier. I'm weird. Like going to even these venues, some of the clubs, it's dead. I have monitors. I don't have in-ears or anything like that. So it's hard to play in a dead room, you know. Yeah. So anyway, what else is going on? Oh, I wanted to show you this thing too. I discovered this on the last show we played in Detroit. The sound man, he's really cool, this guy, and he had all mics and all that stuff, and he said he had this thing, kick block. I went, what's that for? He goes, that's going to hold the bass drum in place. Because what we do with this kit live, my tech, Mark Weber, has two weights from curtain, theater curtains. These things must weigh 40 pounds each. The dead weight. There's two of them to hold the bass drum. Between that and taping the pedal down and the hard, the big legs on this, that holds it. So we tried this, and what this is Velcro, very dense Velcro. It's like foam, lightweight. So he said, let's try it. So we did. The bass drum didn't move. I was like, whoa, dude. Let me see. Yeah. The only problem is you might have is it's certain rugs it won't cling to. Usually, like living room household rugs. Usually the rugs that are in the venues, the short hair rugs or on a riser, it's going to stick. And it holds really, really well. So I just want to tell you about that. I'm going to try it at the whiskey for my second attempt. When they say, wow, this is going to hold the bass drum, then I start playing, you know. See what happens. So anyway, so that's what we got coming up, and so we're actually going to make that 400-mile drive, because that sucks. You know, everybody thinks the road is so fabulous. But when you get into those situations, it's like, you know, on this level, it sucks. So we're going to drive at night up a couple hours, two, three hours. Because after the gig, everybody's up, you know. Then in the morning, we're not up. And then we'll finish the drive in the morning. So, yeah, so I'll show you a couple of things here. This is like making your fills a bit more powerful. So that's a 16th note fill. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E. Take it slower. And I'm starting with the left. Reason why I'm starting with the left, because I like starting with the left. Especially in this shirt. Now, I like the bass drum to be with the right hand. So if I start with the left, put the bass drum, play it with the right hand. See, it sounds a lot more powerful than just this. Here's with the foot. Without it. So now you can play that across the toms. And what I'm doing at the end is I'm doing a double left to get the right hand free to crash on one. Okay. So that's one version of that. Another way. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E. So I'm accenting on the 1E. 1E and a 2E and a 3E. Put the foot with the hands, with the accents. So that's a lot more powerful, the second one, than just this. Even if you put the foot on one. Now two. You can hear it sounds a lot more powerful. Bonzo did a lot of this stuff, too. He did a lot of bass drum with the snare drum fills. And Buddy Rich, if you watch some of his solos, there's parts in there where he's just going mad. All that kind of stuff. And what those are, funny you should ask. Let's see. Sometimes I can't play this stuff slow. All right, so we'll go here slow. So I'm going. Right, left, right, left, left. Right, left, right, left, left. Right. Bass drum. Another one is just doubles. So I'm just doing right, right, left, left, right, 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 left, left, right, right, left, 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 one's cool if you put it together with the first one I showed you, which is right, left, left, right, left, left. Bass drum on the right hand. So those are some exercises to practice and get that bass drum cranking. This one. That one was three with the bass drum. That's harder. Like this. 16th note. See, that's different. So you can try 16th notes straight, like this, then two, three, four, oops, one, two, three, four. So that's a good... hello, Lala.
Hello.
When did you sneak in here?
I snuck in. You didn't see me?
No.
No?
I didn't hear you, that's for sure, because I don't hear crap anymore. She's got to announce herself. If I'm in a room, like I'm facing this way, she comes in the door, she usually goes, hello, hello, or says something. So I don't turn around, oh! Because I didn't even hear her come in, right? So that's from playing loud. And I got earplugs in too. Actually, not only do I have earplugs in, I have matching blue earplugs for the shirt. So we're all fashion coordinated here. But... So those are the power bass drum fills, and they really work well. They're so much stronger than just playing fills. And you don't use them all the time. Just use them some of the time. You know, another example of the bass drum is, I like these. These are kind of a Billy Cobham thing. It's actually in a book that's over somewhere called Stick Control, that's written in the 30s or in the 20s. So, stuff like that. And what you do is get them fast. What I'm doing, it's all single stroke. Left, left, so I can get back to the right. Play them all over the place, but I put the bass drum in as an accent. It adds a nice bit of power to that fill. So anyway, and also there's a 20% coupon floating around on this site now for sawtooth drums. These are sawtooth drums. These quickly are 6-ply of hickory. 6-ply. No filler, no nothing in there. No anything. It's just all hickory, and that's why they sound so good, these drums. They're beautiful. And die-cast hoops, solid steel hoops, solid steel lugs. And also, this has a dual 45-degree bearing edge. What's a bearing edge? It's where the head sits on the drum. So it's the, you could see it when you put a clear head on, it's sitting on an edge, right? So usually the edge is 145 degree. This is two, so it's like this, like a triangle. So it's sitting on there and it gives a great tone like that. And the sizes are 10, 12, 13, 14, 16, 18, 24 by 14. And the snare is a 6.5 inch, and this is the other color these drums come in. This is like a mahogany, not mahogany, but more like a maple color. See, it's all hickory, and comes in that color too. And that color's got a shine to it, more of a gloss. These drums don't have a gloss; they're more dark, like me, like the music I like. So anyway, you can check them out, and there's a 20% coupon for the website, sawtoothdrums.com, I believe it is. But check it out, what's floating around there. So let's take some questions. Lala's going to read me some questions.
Okay.
What do you got there?
Okay. We have a comment. You would look like a sharp-dressed man like ZZ Top.
But I don't play that. If I played that song, we go... And it wouldn't have been a hit.
And are you going to take Lala to dinner because you are a sharp-dressed man?
I tell you what, man, this is deadly to spill something on this. This is a light blue. I don't know if you can see the pattern on this thing.
Oh, you're done.
I'm done.
Your history.
I don't know if I should wear it at the whiskey and just for fun. I might have to get one of those Italian T-shirts, you know, the white ones with the... shoulders and underneath it.
You have to.
Like Brooklyn. Brooklyn! Okay. Thank you for the comment.
The double A cymbals, are they natural or brilliant finished?
The double A cymbals, which are these Sabian double A cymbals, these are natural finish. They're mediums. They're all mediums. This is 20. That's 18. This is a 20-inch medium ride double A. I think the brilliant sound different. They got a little more top end. They're not as loud as these. These cymbals ring. See? They ring for a long time. These are really, really strong cymbals. I play these cymbals with the band. We play loud. And I can hear these cymbals cut over everything. Vivian's too, he's using two angle amps, you know, two bottoms. Loud. So these are just the regular finish. Check them out. Okay.
Do you always play to a click or do you at all?
I only play to a click in the studio here when I do stuff here, like a session. If I'm doing something in a session for somebody, it'll be with a click because it's easier. You got to have a click. Otherwise, you got to follow somebody that's not that steady. And that's hard. You know, you're playing and you're going, yeah. This is cool. Then all of a sudden, the next part comes. What happened? Well, somebody's rushing. So you got to have that click to do this stuff. Live, no click. I'm the click. And then when I record with Last in Line or a band I'm in the studio with, we don't use a click, really. Well, Last in Line, we're a real band. We've been on playing together for 6 years or more and doing lots of gigs, so there's no click. There was no click on any of the Dio records, the Sabbath records either. Back then, we didn't really use a click. Actually, I don't think anybody used a click. Listen to some of the tempos. It's funny. Okay.
Does Last in Line play to clicks, backing tracks?
No. Are you kidding? We are El Natural. Now, we play. There's no backing tracks. No. You know. We used to have a keyboard player which filled in all the stuff underneath it, but now we went a la Led Zeppelin. There's just four of us on stage. There's no backing tracks. It's the four of us pure power. Okay.
Do you wear in-ears when playing live?
No, I'm got monitors blasting away. That's the problem, because I like the monitors really loud and I get the drums loud. And then the guitar's loud, bass, and Andy's trying to sing, and it's hard to hear as well when everything's so loud. If we used in-ears, it would be all under control. One time I did my friend Eric Turner from Warrant used to live close by, and they were playing a winery down here in Temecula. And he said, why don't you come down, you know, come up and play Mob Rules at the end. I said, okay. So they're playing, and I know it's getting to the end of the set, so I start walking toward the stage, go backstage. This is an outdoor venue. And I'm looking at the drums, and I'm thinking, there's no monitors. What do I do? And I don't have in-ears to plug in, and the drummer was using in-ears. So I went, oh, crap, now what? So they finish, and hey, we're going to bring Vinny Appice up there, blah. So I go up there, and they don't have amps on stage, you know? There's no amps. When the band's using the in-ears, you can go on stage. It's so quiet, you could probably whistle. So I thought, uh-oh, how are we going to do this? So I said, all right, follow me. And I heard them a little through the PA, and I just counted off Mob Rules. But I know the song so well and played it so many times that I just played it in my head, and they followed me. And it was good. That worked. But good thing it was that song and not something else, you know. That would have been a train wreck. And nobody told me, oh, you got in-ears? Bring your in-ears. I didn't bring anything. So, but we pulled it off. That was cool. I never actually played with in-ears, so I don't know. I don't know what those are like. I think it kind of, I don't know. It seems like it isolates the person from the audience a little bit. But my thing, monitors are always loud. So, okay.
And what kind of earplugs do you use in your ears?
Really crappy ones.
Yeah.
Those ones I showed you, these are swimming plugs. From Amazon, I got. Cause I used to buy them in the summer at the drugstore. And I had like two pair or a third pair. And then I started losing them. It's like, damn. Then I went on Amazon. I can buy like 12 pairs of different colors for hardly anything. So now I got a million of these things. They cut out the top end a little bit, which is the one that probably damages you the most. And when Lala gets mad at me and screams at me, I can't hear that either because it cuts that out too. Okay.
Looks like you're doing your Buddy Rich look with the shirt on.
I know that. One, two, three. Oh, I was thinking about that too. It's funny you should mention that. You look at the Buddy Rich videos that are on YouTube and stuff. I mean, he's playing in a turtleneck sweater. He's playing in a jacket, you know, with long sleeves underneath. Oh my God! And he's sweating his ass off. You see him going like this, and he's doing that. It's just pouring sweat. He didn't have a fan. I never seen a fan by Buddy. And I always have to have a fan. This little fan here, I don't know if you can see it. Come on, little fan. Let's get back there. This is a great, it's only that big. But I could take this anywhere. I got to have a fan. You know, I play better when I feel that air moving toward me. And my brother Carmine, he doesn't use a fan. But he doesn't sweat as much as me. I'll tell you a funny story. It's about 10 years ago. Carmine and I were playing our show Drum Wars in Italy. And we had an Italian band. And someone in the band, you know, the way we set up is the drums are up front. I'm on this side looking at the audience. I'm on the right. Carmine's on the left. And the band is set up behind us, but the singer can go in front of us. There's not much room, but he can go on the front and sing. So we're playing, and all of a sudden I smell some really bad BO. And it's coming from one of the band behind me, band member. It's Italy. Sometimes people in Europe are a little funny about deodorant. I found out. So I had the fan blowing, which is sucking the air from behind me and pretty much blowing it right in my nose. I'm complaining. Hold my breath. And then I had to turn the fan the other way. And then I had to make some adjustments the next night. You know, we moved them over to a different angle. I moved them over so Carmine gets it. But that was funny because I wasn't expecting that. And it's, oh my God, the fan's blowing it right toward me. Okay, let's take one more question. And then I'll be back next week too. And then maybe next week and a week after. And then we go on the road again where I won't be here. So, okay.
Can you play something in seven?
Seven? That's seven. I don't play much in it. Keep going to four, don't I? But that's seven. But what's funny is there's this lick, these things that I do. So these things are like a four. One E and a six. And then a seven. And this winds up you're playing in seven. Right, left, left foot, right, left foot. So what that is the four. That's the four. And here's a three. Right, left foot. So you got four. And then a three. Put them together. So it's a good way to feel the seven. So you got the four, right, left foot, and then right, left foot. That's a three. Four, three, four. So that's my seven there. So we don't play much seven. You know what I did on some of the old Dio records? I did a roll. Right? Those are 16th notes. One E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a. So instead of doing four within the beat, you do five. Now that's odd. I'm still in four, but I'm doing five notes instead of four. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 E and a 5. 4. See, now that 5, those 5 beats have to be within that time, within that tempo. You got to be smooth. They're not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What's up there? What's up there? No, it's got to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4, 5. Here's a stupid way to remember it: Vinnie Appice, Vinnie Appice, Vinnie Appice, Vinnie Appice. Now funny? Then there's a seven. That's an eight. Eight. Even. Seven. If you want a new thing to work on, who's that? Gary Chafee book. Gary's an unbelievable drummer and instructor from Boston. And he has this stuff in a book. It's called Patterns, I think. Is it Patterns? I don't know. It's Gary Chafee and Fives and Sevens. And he does stuff with these things that are crazy. So in rock, I just thought that might be cool. I'm playing the end of the song. Nobody noticed. Regular. Even. Then I did a five. Regular. Seven. Here comes seven. It's crazy. The way you know you're doing it right is you wind up alternating the stick. One, two, three, four, five. Left. See? Right. Left. I'm sorry. Right. Left. Right. That's the way you know you're doing it correctly. Those are cool. If you want another weird place to go in your drumming, start studying those things. Gary Chafee has a book. Try doing it with a metronome so you can't cheat. So you go one, like one, two, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, three, four, one, two, three, four, five, one, two, three, four, five, one, two, three, four, five, one, two, three. See, the metronome is just staying in time. You got to fit easy four notes in, then you got to fit five notes in, then try seven, and it'll be all five and seven will be alternating. There's even a nine, but I don't do the nine. So anyway, thanks for joining me, and thank you, Sawtooth. And these are the fabulous hickory drums I'll be using at the Whiskey in the next three shows. And check out the coupon online. And I'll see you next week, or I'll see you on the weekend at the shows. Right, Lala?
Yep, I'll be there.
You want to play keyboards?
Okay.
She doesn't play keyboards. But
I don't.
Okay, so see you guys.